Hello, and welcome back to the Divine Beast Cave, Floor 3. This episode, we go through Floor 3 and then rebuild the town for what we find. Last episode, same with Floor 2. So, that's basically how this game works. You go through a dungeon, and also tutorial, man. This doesn't happen past the first dungeon, don't worry about it. I'm back. Exciting, eh? Don't give me that look. This is for your benefit. Now, here's the intermediate course. I won't repeat myself, so listen carefully. So, more tutorial, lock on. I already told you about that. So, however, you may not have known that L1 and R1 change what they do in lock on. Pressing L1 switches it to another enemy. Pushing it multiple times changes between all enemies in view. R1 is guard, which is basically garbage. The only time to use guard, really, is when you're surrounded. When you're guaranteed to be hit, guard it. Otherwise, don't, because you'll be knocked back, the enemy will be knocked back, and then you won't be able to hit it. So, changing attributes, you can change weapons, elemental attribute, elements do different things to different enemies. Higher an element is on an enemy, the more elemental damage it'll do. So, I don't ever put attachments on the base dagger, because base dagger can't status break, which is a thing that you can only do with breakable weapons. Status break is something you want to do a lot. Whenever odd gaffer, that's the shopkeeper. Anyway, whenever a weapon reaches plus 5, or a level 5, I guess, get over here, bat! Don't hit me! Alright. Whenever a weapon reaches level 5, you're able to status break it, and move 60% of its stats onto another weapon. Which is exceedingly powerful. I am bad! I want to be able to carry more than one poison on me at one, more than one poison. This is the enemy that's worse. You will see in a moment. Attacking him does not stop his attack. So, you just have to attack him twice and then run away. The second problem with him is attacking him reduces your weapon HP by 3. Instead of the normal 1 for normal enemies. So, hey, I got my house! Yay! My house. In the middle of my town, I guess. Whatever. Alright, what's in the chest? We got a map. I hate these enemies. So sometimes they'll do a quicker attack as well. So yeah, every time I attack him, it goes down by 3 or 4 sometimes even. So, I want to hit you one more time, thank you. Alright. Now that my weapon is almost totally broken, I repair it. You want to get it as close to 0 as possible so you don't waste repair powder. Well, I managed to hit them both with that attack. That's nice. When an enemy is dying, you can't hit them again, so don't worry about doing another attack. With melee characters, at least, because melee characters, if they miss with their weapon, the weapon doesn't take any damage. So, don't worry about it. Unless you're using a special attack, which I'm not going to do, because special attacks take way too much weapon HP to use, and they don't do that much more damage. The only time I'm using special attacks is when it's required, because certain special attacks are actually required to go through doors. Hey! On this floor, I can see on the map, we have a little water area in the right middle room-ish area. I don't like fighting you, because you take way too much weapon HP. Although, if I just get a free repair powder, that makes my life easier. Nice. Max, nice! Don't ever hit them 3 times. Don't do what I did. It's a bad idea. Do as I say, not as I do, because I almost got hit. And those guys do a lot of damage. Yeah, I hate the statues. They have way too much health. They do a lot of damage, they don't take recoil, so they don't stop attacking when you hit them, and they do a lot of damage to your weapon as well. There is nothing to like about them. Well, not until you get a ranged character, because certain characters have ranged weapons. So, it's hey, we got the magical crystal, that's nice. Now then, on, I believe, floor 5 and below, we can find mimics. Whoop. Yay! I'm gonna open that in a moment. Actually, no, I should open it right now. So, these things. Wrong side. It's locked. Forcing it open may activate a trap. So, force it by guessing the trap. Explosion. Explosion does a bunch of damage. Curse makes you unable to switch weapons. I don't care. And poison just will do a lot of damage. If it's an explosion, I might die immediately. So let's heal myself before I open this thing. Before I attempt to open it, at least. So now I should have just gone to the water spout, shouldn't I have? I didn't think of that. Oh well. I don't have a treasure chest key, so let's guess the trap. I'm going to guess it's poison, because I don't have an antidote to cure it. Failed to release it, it was an explosion. Ow. So, if it's an explosion, you can just guess it the second time, and then the trap's released. And we get the worst weapon. Dang it, why? So you have to go into weapons to equip weapons. Problem with the bone rapier. Endurance, 32. Endurance, 20. And it has less weapon HP. Made of bone, ability unknown. I don't care. Bone rapier has really good attack, no endurance, really high speed, and really high magic. I still hate it, though. I'm going to equip it and try to keep it alive if I can. But look at this garbage. So it does really nice damage, but it has no weapon health. Oh, another large chest. Nice. Maybe I'll actually get something I care about. I get Samshir. That's actually not a bad weapon. So Samshir does better damage, better endurance, less speed, and less magic. So, and slightly higher weapon HP. So I'm going to be using this one for a while. This is not my favorite weapon from the first dungeon. We have not seen it yet. But there are only three weapons you can find. We found two weapons that I like less. So luck's not going well today. Let's see what we got. We got a Gasher. It's dead. So the way attack power works is you'll be doing that much damage, pretty much. If you see an attack stat, that's about how much damage you're going to be doing per hit. If it's a rapid-fire weapon, which we'll see later, it'll do less damage, but do it much faster. So, this also seems to be electric elemental, which I don't know what's weak to that. I don't think anything in the first dungeon is. I mean, I know what types of enemies are weak to it, I just don't think there are any in the first dungeon. I misspoke. Alright, let's see what we got in this one. One of my favorite items to... Oh my gosh, why is my luck the worst with poison right now? I just two-shot that thing. That was great. The last possible enemy was carrying the Grand Crest. That is not common. So, yeah. Anyway, we're done here. We've gotten everything. We're heading out. One of my favorite items to put in that top thing is something we haven't seen yet. It's called Dran's Feather. When I played the game the first time, I never used it because I was like, well, it breaks super quickly because in its description it says it breaks quickly. So, let's move the trees over here. So I never used it, because I thought, well, if it's gonna break quickly, I'm not ever... there's no reason to ever use it. because all it does is increase your movement speed for a little bit. Yeah, that increase of movement speed, you press square, you hold down square, and you just sprint. Let's see, did we get anything that we can place? We can place the llama. And then we got Gaffer's buggy. Odd Gaffer really likes to be placed in a location that has a lot of people around it. That's going to be about this location. So we're going to put them there. Odd Gaffer goes right there. We cannot currently finish his house, which is a good thing. We don't want to finish his house first. There's someone else's house that we have not seen yet. We want to finish their house before we finish Odd Gaffer. Hi, Dragon. This is Odd Gaffer's item shop. Come by anytime. So, he has an item shop. We can't do shopping yet, so he needs goods and a sign. We are not going to finish his house until we get someone named Pike into town. Because Pike is the repairman, basically. If he is not here, also my llama, if he is not here when we finish Odd Gaffer's buggy, Odd Gaffer tries to fix the sign himself, hurts himself, and then we get worse items in the shop. So you want Pike here before you finish Odd Gaffer's buggy, so that you get better items in the shop. And it's when you finish it, not when you start placing it down. So don't worry about that. Just gonna look around for any red boxes before we end the episode here. Or this could happen. That works too. So we finished one house. We have my house placed. And the thing about my house, the thing that the main character's mom wants is for the window. Hang on. There we go. The window, that one. She wants that window to be facing the way the sun rises. So the total opposite direction from how I have it right now. So let's rotate it around. And put it, I guess, there. That works. That works fine. And trees, I don't know where to put you. Wait, I have made a mistake. Hang on, need to fix things. So, I'm changing this because houses need an area of 2 to be placed. Which means, there we go, that should work. So houses need an area of 2x3 to be placed. So you need an area of 2 to be able to place the house there. Those are the two spots you can, anyway. So that was the reason I did that. Anyway, eventually we'll get a bridge that we can place to finish that off. I'm just gonna build the town like this, anyway. I will see you all next time. I'm going to go get the items from the mayor, and then I will see you back in the dungeon for floor 4. And just a warning, save before you enter floor 4. Okay, see you then.